So just now, me, Governor mentioned planning, to emphasize the planning is important, and I would like to focus on planning issue. So we some case studies, and I would like to give my intervention with four aspects. I mean, from vision to identify issues, and give a very, very brief introduction to methodology. And finally, I would show a case studies. So from vision to specific case, in my mind, it's a process from a forest tree to a specific tree. So talking about vision, we have to consider the population change, I mean, the total amount, the distribution, especially as the emerging economy, I mean, in China, in the coming decades, we will expect several hundred million rural people, I mean, to move into city. And what does it mean, I mean, when this population distribution change? So that means we need more raw materials, more urban infrastructure, especially transport, housing infrastructures to make people with higher living standards to feel more convenient to live. If you look at these figures, I mean, every hour we have additional inhabitants increase all over the world, especially in emerging economy, if you look at India and China. And this also show the relationship between urbanization and motorization. So anyway, we need to face the challenge. And regarding the source of greenhouse gas emission, transport sector is becoming an increasing source in emerging economies. If we look back, 10 years ago or 20 years ago, in China, in the major mega cities like Beijing and Shanghai and Guangzhou, transport just account for very, very limited share of the carbon emission. But now we are observing very rapid increase of private car, energy use, and carbon emission, as well as NOx, PM10, and other local pollutants. And this is a possible trajectories, I mean, for different countries, I mean, in terms of the relationship between GDP per capita and energy use for transport. And then we are thinking how to make the urbanization towards low carbon direction. So at least here, we need to think first to develop with lower emission. But meanwhile, anyway, we need to make development. That means we think both the people and the environment. So anyway, nobody can stop the process, I mean, to make people living better off. But meanwhile, we need to try to find the new, more creative, more innovative pathway towards the future, especially for emerging economy. So for the moment, in front of us, we have three pathways in general to follow. One, I would like to say, the higher one, so experienced by the United States, by Australia, Canada. I mean, for the same Human Development Index, consume higher energy and with higher per capita emission. So obviously, this is not the way China should follow. And a better way is European way or the Japanese way. I mean, the same Human Development Index, but lower emission, higher energy efficiency in general. It's good. It's better than the previous way. But even though I'm thinking, I mean, with huge population, I mean, for example, together with India, China and India account for over 40% of the human being population. If those population follow the lifestyle for US and Europe, I don't think the globe can affordable for I mean for energy supply, for greenhouse gas emission. So that means China, India, and other emerging economies should create the third way. I mean, to reach the same welfare, the same human development, but meanwhile, to emit much, much less. So where in the way? Actually, this is the central concern for the strategic consideration for the coming decades for emerging economies, especially for China. As you know, in terms of policy agendas, recently China is in a crucial moment to develop its 12th five-year plan or 10-year medium-term strategies, and these should become the central components of the strategy. And we also try to set up the scenario for the future emission, I mean greenhouse gas emission. So we have different way to go, and then we consider by which technological roadmap we can reach lower carbon development. This shows for the moment energy efficiency will continue to be the major contributor for emission reduction. But within efficiency technology, I would like to say transport will play increasing role. And furthermore, from these micro big pictures at national level, we go to level, because China is so huge. Any targets, any policies and strategies will be implemented at provincial, municipal, and county levels, at enterprises level. And then we try to link, HDI, Human Development Report, Index, and carbon productivity, to see the relationship. The statistical data tells us, actually, in terms of carbon productivity, the two should be consistent with each other. That means development doesn't necessarily mean the limitation of development, but doesn't mean the limitation. Emission control doesn't necessarily mean the limitation of development, but they should go along the same way. And but if you just say, oh, we establish a model for Chinese city, this will be likely wrong, because China is so diversified, even for provinces and cities. And further research show for over 30 provinces and cities, we have different ways for them to develop, in terms of energy use and carbon productivity. That we found, with the historic empirical data, we found there are at least five sub pathways for the provinces and cities in China to develop. Why? Because there is a diversified situation in terms of energy supply, in terms of economic development level, in terms of geographical location. So we cannot find a single, there is no single fit all. So that means no single size fit all. So we need to develop very diversified strategies for different types of provinces and cities. So this is another evidence to show the diversities. And we also observed in the past, five years, the rapid change of energy intensity all over China, with different geographical location. And then based on these kind of visions, we try to identify the core issues. For the moment, within the context of Chinese policy agendas, we are thinking about first how to integrate the social economic restructuring with environmentally smart development. Actually, again, this is becoming a central consideration for the 12th five-year plan. I mean, restructuring and environmentally smart. Secondly, how to allocate and implement the national target. As you know, Chinese government has set up the emission, I mean, carbon intensity target, I mean, 40 to 45 reduction by 2020, and how to allocate it, by which way? I mean, how much for Inner Mongolia, how much for Canton provinces? And the other issue is what behavior the local stakeholders should have. I mean, to buy a very large car, to have larger size of houses, and what policies and the technology should be should economic sectors adopt, and finally, how should we plan the urbanization? So then we develop, I mean, WRI together is partners in China, I mean, Tsinghua University and Renmin University. We develop series of methodologies and the toolkits to support the analysis for the policies and the on-the-ground practical solutions.